Hi, welcome back. Or if you're just joining, my name is Maya, and welcome to my channel, Cranleyplace, where I'm focused on Hermès scarf style, knot tutorials, and more. Before we get started, let me give a shout out to all the new channel members and special welcome to the new knot connoisseurs and elegant insiders. If you haven't already, be sure to check out the membership options. In this video, I'll discuss a 90cm silk twill from Hermès' Spring-Summer 2024 collection, Hermès Flagship by Dimitri Rybaltchenko. I'll discuss some background about the artist, a bit about the maritime theme behind the design, and then take a deep dive into one of the available colorways to talk about color pairing possibilities. Let's get started! Dimitri Rybaltchenko is a renowned Hermès scarf designer, known for his vivid imagination and enchanting creations. Born into a cosmopolitan artistic family with French and Ukrainian roots, Dimitri's background includes diverse arts such as opera, painting, architecture, drawing, and sculpture. As a result, his artistry spans across various mediums, techniques, and styles. As you may know, he comes from a family of artists who have played a major role in the Maison's success. Dimitri is the son of Vladimir Rybaltchenko, who was the great-nephew of Philippe Ledeux. Like some of the other Hermès artists, there's not much published about him biographically, but throughout his collaboration with Hermès, he has designed dozens of scarves, many of which have become highly collectible. Some of his designs include Perle du Kenya, Cheval Surprise, Noël au 24 Faubourg, L'Étoile de Paris, Offrande d'un jour, Magic Kelly, Les Facettes de Picasso, and many more. His artistry also extends beyond scarf design, having created objects and decorations for Hermès, Fendi, Dior, and Saint Laurent, among others, with work ranging from silks, jewelry, and ceramics to furniture and other decor. This design is inspired by the 24 Faubourg flagship store in Paris, reimagined in the form of a ship. Given the pun, I wanted to spend a few minutes on the flagship concept itself in maritime history. Originating in the age of sail and naval warfare, the term flagship carried profound significance within fleet dynamics. Flagship originally referred to the ship in a fleet that carried the commanding officer and displayed the commander's flag or pennant. It served as a symbol of authority and leadership within naval fleets. The concept of a flagship extends back centuries to the age of sail and naval warfare, where fleets were often led by the most powerful or strategically significant vessel. In the vast expanse of the open sea, where communication was challenging and coordination vital, the flagship stood as the linchpin of command and control. It was not merely a vessel of imposing size or strength, although these attributes often characterized it. Instead, the flagship was distinguished by the presence of the commanding officer, whose authority was symbolized by the hoisting of their flag or pennant. This symbolic act, known as flying the flag, visually communicated the commander's presence and served as a rallying point for the fleet. From the vantage point of the flagship's deck, the commanding officer could oversee the unfolding of naval engagements, issue orders via signals or messengers, and exert strategic influence over the course of battle. Moreover, the flagship embodied leadership and prestige within naval fleets. Its selection often reflected careful consideration, with factors such as firepower, maneuverability, and the experience of the commanding officer considered. In some cases, particularly during decisive confrontations, the flagship's role extended beyond mere command to embody the very essence of national pride and strategic ambition. Across centuries of naval history, the concept of the flagship remained constant amid the ever-changing tides of warfare and technology. Whether in the era of wooden ships or canvas sails, or the modern age of steel behemoths and advanced weaponry, the flagship retained its symbolic significance as a nexus of authority and leadership on the high seas. Now let's take a look at one of the colorways to consider color pairing possibilities. For this, I'll use the Bleu Ciel, Vert de Gris, Rose colorway. I chose this one because historically I've shied away from seemingly more monochromatic colorways like this for fear that they would be too limiting. But let's see how this is going to work with other colors around the wheel. Starting with the colors in the name, Blue Ciel is the sky blue. Verdigris literally translates to green of gray, or generally a grayish, greenish, bluish deposit that forms on copper, brass, or bronze surfaces. By the way, it is also a poison. Then rose is the pale violetic pink. There are also other blues, greens, yellows, oranges, gray, brown, black, and white. Blue, as we know, has a complementary color opposite in orange and neighboring colors of green and purple. For verdigris, or the grayish green, its complementary color opposite is red, and adjacent colors include yellow and blue. Pink technically sits between red and orange, so its color wheel opposite is green. Green, we just spoke about, being opposite of pink, and its neighbors include blue and yellow. Yellow sits across the color wheel from purple, and its neighboring hues include green and orange. Orange, as already mentioned, sits opposite blue on the color wheel, and adjacent colors include red and yellow. Then the neutrals, gray, brown, black, and white pair with anything. Red is the only color we don't see outright, but we'll take a look to see if we can make this colorway work with shades of that hue as well. So there you have it, some background about the artist, design inspiration, and styling possibilities for this scarf from Hermès's Spring-Summer 2024 season. Please like and share the video if you enjoyed it, and let me know what you think in the comments. In future episodes, I'll share other scarf reviews, tutorials, and more, so be sure to hit that subscribe button to be notified of new videos. Thanks again for joining me today. Until next time!